Vulkite Berzerkers are fearsome mercenary warriors who've seen many battles across the mortal realms. They're likely to form the core part of your Fyreslayer army. So what I'm going to do is show you how to paint one in the colours of the Vostarg Lodge, which are the ones that you'll have seen on the box. So we'll be covering how to paint the skin, that fiery hair, and also some really cool glowing rune effects as well. So grab your brushes and paints and let's go! So the first thing we're going to do is start by painting the skin. And because that covers the majority of the model, it's a great place to begin. And as you can see, I've started by spraying my model with an undercoat of Corax White, which means our first paint is going to be Cadian Flesh Tone. We're going to apply that in an all-over layer. So I'm going to grab my Cadian Flesh Tone and give it a good shape before I use it. And then I'm going to use my small base coat brush to apply this. I'm going to get a good amount onto the palette. And also add a little bit of water just to thin the paint down so it goes on the model nice and smoothly. And so, just going to apply this all over the skin, taking care to get it in all of the skin. Now don't worry if you get it on any of the other bits, because we'll be painting those later. Just remember to apply your paint in nice thin layers so you don't obscure any detail. You will need two thin coats to get a nice smooth finish on this. Right, that's the all over layer of Cadian Flesh Tone now done. And the next thing we're going to do is add some depth to the skin using an all over shade of Reichland Flesh Shade. So I'm using my medium shade brush to apply this. I'm just going to get a good amount onto my palette. Just use it to control how much is on my brush. It's really handy for shades. And then I'm just going to apply it all over the skin, making sure you get it in all the recesses. Just make sure it doesn't pool anywhere because it'll start to obscure detail. Just keep an eye out. Just remember to give it enough time to dry before applying the next stage. About half an hour should be fine. Now that the shade is completely dry, you can see that it's really brought out all the details, but it has darkened down the skin quite a bit. So what we're going to do is go back to Cadian Flesh Tone and apply a layer, but this time we'll be applying it just a little bit differently in a more focused way. So I'll be using my small layer brush to apply this. So I'm just going to get some paint onto the palette. Also add a little bit of water as well, just to thin the paint down so it goes on the model nice and smoothly. It's really important for this stage. So once you've done that, I'm just going to avoid all the places where the shade has settled the most. So there's not as much shade on the nose. So I'm just going to paint that. And it has settled down the side of the nose just there. So I'm going to avoid that and just paint under his eye. Like that. You see that it's really brought out the detail already. Now on the arm it's slightly different because they are a little bit smoother. So I'm just going to apply it here because I can see the shade has settled just above. And then I'm going to avoid it and just apply it above just like that. Now just do this all around the model until you've painted all the skin. With that layer of Cadian Flesh Tone applied, you can see that it's really brightened the skin back up and has also really helped bring out those details as well. And the next thing we're going to do is define those details even further with a highlight of Kislev Flesh. And for that, I'll be using my Artificer brush. So I'm just going to grab some paint onto the palette and also add a little bit of water just to thin the paint down so I can get a nice smooth highlight. I'm going to twist my brush to get a good point. And then what we're looking for here is the most defined edges. So the bridge of the nose is a great place to start. And there, and also under his eye as well. You see it's really brought out those features. And on the muscles, what we're looking for again is the most defined edges. So I'm going to highlight along here, just under the shade, like that. And again, above. Just go around until you've got all the ones around the model. With all the highlights now done, that's the skin finished. And what we're going to do now is move on to one of the most prominent features of the Fyreslayers, and that's their hair and beards. For that, we're going to start with a base coat of Jacaro Orange. I'll be using my medium base brush to apply this. I'll just grab my brush, also get some paint onto the palette. Now this should form the basis of their bright orange hair. So just get the model, and we're just going to apply it all over the hair. Making sure you get into all those recesses, get a nice even coverage. Just remember to get all the hair, especially that inside the crest just there. And their beards as well. And just carry on till you've got all the hair. Try not to get it on any of the bits you've already painted. With the base coat now applied, the next thing we're going to do is really build up that bright orange colour for the hair with a layer of Troll Slayer Orange. So I'm going to be using my medium base brush to apply this as well, because we're going to apply it in exactly the same way as we did the base layer. I'm going to grab some paint, a little bit of water, and then we've got some paint ready. Just going to apply it in exactly the same way, just all over the hair, getting it into all the recesses as well. You will need two thin coats to get a nice, even finish on this. Just keep going until you've got all the hair. With that layer applied, you can see that the hair and beard is now a really nice, bright, fiery orange. So the next thing we're going to do is add some depth to the hair and beard with an all-over shade of Fugan Orange. So I'll be using my medium shade brush to apply this. So we'll be applying it all over the hair and beard. So I'm just going to get a good amount on my palette so I can control how much is on my brush. And then, when you've got your shade, we're just going to be applying it all over the hair, just making sure it goes into all the recesses. And it will gather a little bit more at the top recesses here. So you don't want too much to gather there because you will lose some detail. So just move it around with your brush and make sure you get all of the hair and beard. As always, with a shade, give it enough time to dry before applying the next stage. About 30 minutes should be fine. With the shade now completely dry, you can see that it's really brought out all the detail in the hair and the beard. The next thing we're going to do is just add some different tones of colour to the hair and the beard, just to bring out that really fiery look that we're going for. So for that, I'm going to be using a shade of Caraberg Crimson. This time I'll be using my medium layer brush to apply it, because I just need a bit more control over the shade this time. So I'm just going to get some shade like that. And then what I'm going to do is, this time we're not going to apply it all over the hair, we're just going to apply it halfway up, like that. If you need to, just add some little sprogs here and there, just to break up the line a little bit. But don't worry if it looks a bit strange at the moment, because we'll bring it all together later on. Most important thing at the moment is to get a nice even shade. Then on the beard, just do it exactly the same, working from the roots to about halfway through. And as always with a shade, just give it enough time to dry. About half an hour should be fine. Now that the Caraberg Crimson shade's completely dry, the next thing we're going to do is add some darkness to the fiery effect with a shade of Noln Oil. And again, I'll be using my medium layer brush to apply this. I'm just going to get some shade onto the palette and get a good amount on my brush as well. And what we're going to be doing this time is just applying it to the very roots of the hair. So just about halfway through your shade of Caraberg Crimson, like that. And then on the beard, again from the roots to about halfway through your last shade. And again, give it enough time to dry. About half an hour should be fine. With the shade of Noln Oil now completely dry, you can see that the beard and the hair are looking really nice and fiery. So the next thing we're going to do is bring out all the details in the hair with a dry brush of Kindle Flame. So I'm going to be using my small dry brush to apply this. I'm just going to get some of the paint out and put it on this tissue and just really work it in amongst the bristles. And you just want to work it in until there's almost no paint left on your brush. And then what we're going to do is just apply it over the tops of the hair like that, over the ridges. Just apply it nice and lightly to begin with and build up the effect till you're happy with it. It's much easier to add paint than it is to take it away. You see it's really highlighting all those ridges. And do exactly the same on the beard. With that dry brush now done, you can see that it's really brought out all the detail. And the last step we're going to do on the hair and the beard is really bring out those fiery tones with an all-over glaze of Lamenter's Yellow. So I'll be using my medium layer brush to apply this because I just want as much control over the glaze as I can get. So I'll get a good amount onto my palette so I can control how much is on my brush. And then what we're going to do is just apply it all over the hair like that. You see that's really bring out those nice warm tones. Just apply it all over and just watch out for pooling as it dries. So you don't want too much on there. With the glaze now completely dry, that's the hair finished. And the next thing I'm going to move on to paint is all the leather and the weapon handles too. So we're going to be starting with a base coat of Abaddon Black and then highlighting up with Eshin Grey. So I'm going to start with Abaddon Black, be using my small base brush to apply this. Grab some paint, just a bit more, and add a little bit of water as well, just to thin the paint down so it goes on nice and smoothly. And then, when you've got some paint, just going to apply it all over the leather and start with the loincloth. And don't worry if you get it on any of the bits that are meant to be gold, because we'll be painting those later. So just work your way around the model, get all the leather and also the weapon handles too. With the base coat now dry, the next thing we need to do is add some highlights with Eshin Grey. So I'm going to start down here and just start highlighting along the edges like that. I'll just be as neat as possible. If you do make a mistake, don't worry, you can neaten up later with a bit of Abaddon Black. With those highlights now done, the next thing we're going to move on to paint is his armour and his weapons. And for that, I'll be starting with a base coat of Lead Belcher and my small base brush. So I'm just going to grab some paint like that. And also, again, add a little bit of water. Just make sure it goes on nice and smoothly. And then what we'll be doing is applying it to the weapon heads. So the axe heads just here, like that. And also on his helmet too. So don't worry if you get it on any of the raised bits that are going to be gold. So we'll be painting those in a little bit. And just here as well. Just carry on until you've got all the bits that are going to be silver. With the base coat of Lead Belcher now applied, the next thing we're going to do is add some depth to the metal with an all-over shade of Nuln Oil. I'll be using my medium shade brush to do this. So I'm just going to grab some shade onto the palette so I can control how much is on my brush. Once you've got a good amount, what we're going to do is just apply it all over the bits that we painted Lead Belcher, making sure it gets into all of those recesses. And just keep an eye out for pooling as it dries. Remove any excess shade with your brush. And as always, give it enough time to dry. About half an hour should be fine. Now that the shade is completely dry, you can see that it's really added some depth to the metal. But it has darkened down a little bit and given it a matte finish. So the next thing we're going to do is go back to Lead Belcher and apply a layer. And this should really brighten it back up and give it a shiny, steely finish. So I'm just going to grab some paint onto the palette and also add a little bit of water. I'll be using my medium layer brush to apply this. So once you've got a good amount on your brush, I'm going to start with the axe like that. And what we'll be doing is just applying the Lead Belcher, going around avoiding all the recesses. So I'm just going to apply it along here, along the axe head like that. And then avoiding this recess, just applying it over here as well. So just go around avoiding all the recesses. And you might need two thin coats to get a nice even finish on this. With that layer of Lead Belcher now applied, you can see that it's really brightened the metal back up. So the next thing we need to do is paint all the gold on the model. For that, I'm going to be applying a base coat of Retributor Armor. I'll be using my small base brush to apply this. I'm going to get some paint onto the palette, and as usual, just add a little bit of water. Once you've got a good amount on your brush, be starting on the helmet, and just paint all of the bits that are meant to be gold, gold. Now there is a lot of it on the model, so just take your time and work your way around. You will need two thin coats to get a nice even finish on this. With the base coat of gold now done, the next thing I'm going to do is give it a quick coat of Reichland Flesh Shade, just to really bring out all those details. I'll be using my medium layer brush to apply this shade, because I want as much control over the shade as I can get, because we've already painted a lot of the model, so I don't want to get it on any of the bits that we've already painted. So once you've loaded up your brush, I'm going to start on the crest, and just shade all of the bits that we've painted gold. And you just want it to settle in all the recesses. Just take your time and work your way around the model. With the shade now completely dry, what we're going to do now is go back to Retributor Armor and just apply a layer just to brighten the gold back up, just like we did with the silver, so it's nice and shiny. So I'll be using my small layer brush to apply this, just because some of the bits are a little bit tricky and I want as much control as I can get. So I'm just going to pop a little water there as well. Goes on nice and smoothly, and then
I'm just going to start on the crest. So what we're looking to do here is just apply it and avoid all the recesses. Leave them nice and dark. Just work your way around the model till you've got them all. Now on the flatter areas, you might need two coats to get a nice even finish.
Now that we've brightened the gold back up, the next thing we're going to do is add some highlights to both the gold and the silver with Runefang steel. For that, I'll be using my artifice brush to apply that so I can get as much control as possible. I'm just going to add a little bit of water as well and twist my brush to get a good point.
And then I'm just going to start on the crest with the gold. What you want to do is just highlight the most raised edges, like along here, along here too. And on the silver, I'm going to do the axe head. And for these kind of sharp edges, what you can do is get your brush at a 45 degree angle, just sweep it along like that for a nice sharp highlight. Just go around until you've got all the edges on the model.
There you go, that's all the highlights on the metal finished. There's only one thing left to paint on the model, and that's the glowing runes in the skin. So for that, we're going to start with a base coat of corn red, and then apply a thinner layer of troll slayer orange. Following that, Uriel yellow, and then finally add some highlights with white scar. I'll be using my artificer brush to apply all of this, and I'm going to start with some corn red. So I'm going to pop some on the palette,
and also add a little bit of water, just so it goes on nice and smoothly. And get a nice point in your brush. I'm going to start with this rune up here on the shoulder. So what you want to do is just apply it all over the rune, just taking care not to get into any of the recesses either side. Just take your time and get all the runes on the skin.
With the runes now base coated, the next thing we need to do is just get some Troll Slayer Orange and, using my artifice brush again, just paint it through the middle of the rune, just like that, leaving some corn red either side. You will need two thin coats to get a nice solid finish on this. With that done, the next thing we need to do is apply some Uriel yellow just in exactly the same way. So just painting it through the middle of the rune like that, trying to keep some Troll Slayer orange showing either side. You will need two thin coats to get a nice even finish. The final thing that we have to do is just add some highlights with white scar. So I'm just going to be applying these just on the extreme edges and corners of the rune. Just like that. Just really, really carefully. It will really make it look like it's glowing.
And there we go. That's your Vulkite Berzerker finished. Ready to hurl himself into battle. Axes at the ready.
You can see that I've based mine with a dark grey base. Just remember that when you're basing yours, just keep it consistent with the rest of your collection. Now there's just a few things to remember when painting your Vulkite Berzerker. So when you're applying your paint, just apply it in nice thin layers, especially on things like the skin. Help you get a really nice smooth finish. And also, when you're dry brushing, just remember to apply it sparingly at first and just build the effect up. It's much easier to add paint than it is to take it away. And finally, when you're highlighting, just be as neat as possible, especially on things like the runes. It'll help you get the best effect. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and we'll see you again real soon for more.
If you enjoyed that tutorial and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to our YouTube channel, Warhammer TV, which is full of loads of other tutorials, but also trailers and miniature showcases too.
If you want to watch some right now, why not check out some of the videos down below?